Hello everyone. Last time we have explained about the morphology and types of endoplasmic reticulum. Today we will explain the functions of endoplasmic reticulum. The first function of the endoplasmic reticulum, mechanical support. The endoplasmic reticulum divides the fluid content of the cell into the compartments and thus provides additional mechanical support for the colloidal structure or the fluid contents of the cytoplasm, and these compartments make possible the existence of ionic gradients and the electrical potentials along the ER membranes. So, the endoplasmic reticulum having the complex structure of cisternae or lamellae, then tubules and the vesicles, then also possessing two type of ER, endoplasmic reticulum, that is rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum, enclosing the cavity, fluid filled cavity, and stores different type of biochemicals which are produced by them, that is in the form of proteins or lipids or carbohydrates, or the combination of the lipids and carbohydrates, that is in the form of glycolipids or the phospholipids, which are produced by smooth endoplasmic reticulum and are then stored in the cavities enclosed in the endoplasmic reticulum of respective type. And thus, this separates these fluid contents or the chemicals which are in the form of fluid, which are produced or synthesized by rough ER or smooth ER, but are enclosed in the cavities and are then separated from the rest of cytoplasm. So, remaining cytoplasm ultimately kept away from the biochemicals or the number of substances produced by the ER endoplasmic reticulum. So, these are filled up into the spaces of the rough or smooth endoplasmic reticulum, or different components of the endoplasmic reticulum may be in the tubules or in the vesicles, but providing mechanical support to the liquid components or the colloidal components of the cytoplasm and also keeping separate from one another. So, it provides mechanical support. Then cellular metabolism. The membrane of the reticulum, the membrane of the endoplasmic reticulum provides an increased surface area for the metabolic activities within the cytoplasm, such as synthesis of cholesterol, triglycerides and other lipids, indicating their probable role in the lipid metabolism. The membrane of the reticulum, endoplasmic reticulum, that is a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The membrane of smooth endoplasmic reticulum provides increased surface for the metabolic activities in the cytoplasm, such as synthesis of cholesterol, triglyceride and other lipids. So, these are the different type of lipids and these are synthesized by the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, indicating their probable role in the lipid metabolism or in a synthesis of lipids performing the role of lipid synthesis as a part of cellular metabolism. Then protein synthesis. Proteins are synthesized on the ribosomes and enter the ER cisternae. So, whatever the proteins synthesized by the ribosomes of rough endoplasmic reticulum, due to presence of ribosomes getting involved in the process of protein synthesis. So, the ribosomes of the rough endoplasmic reticulum synthesize the proteins, which are then stored in the space or the cavity of the cisternae of the ER through channels in the membrane. So, the proteins are synthesized on the ribosomes and which are then enter the endoplasmic reticulum cisternae through the channels in the membrane. Endoplasmic reticulum facilitates protein folding and the transport of the synthesized proteins in a sacs. It has been pointed out that the pre-ribosomes are not as active as in a protein synthesis, as they are associated with the ER. Means the free ribosomes are not much active. The free ribosomes, when present in the cytoplasmic matrix, are not much active in the process of protein synthesis, but the ribosomes which are in association with the ER membrane or in the form of propendoplasmic reticulum getting involved actively or performing the role of protein synthesis in the form of propendoplasmic reticulum. Because the free ribosomes are not getting involved in the process of protein synthesis easily, but when they are associated with the ER performing the better role of protein synthesis with ER. This suggests that the ER membrane contributes in some way to the efficiency of the process of protein synthesis. So, ER membrane thus increasing, endoplasmic reticulum membrane thus increasing the efficiency of the protein synthesis or the process of protein synthesis due to presence of ribosomes on the ER membrane to form rough endoplasmic reticulum. In the pancreatic acinar cells, pancreatic acini cells of the dog, dense granules are seen in the cisternae. In the liver cell of salamander, Berchasops attenuatus, protein crystals have been found in the granular cisternae. So, this is the indicative of cellular metabolism, that is a synthesis of the proteins either in the gland cells like pancreas. So, pancreatic acini or the gland cells of the pancreatic acini in the dog possessing dense granules in the cisternae or the liver cell of the salamander, possessing protein crystals, liver cell of the salamander that is Berchasops attenuatus. This is the genus species of the salamander, liver cells of which possessing crystals, protein crystals in the cytoplasm of hepatic cells containing the protein crystals in the cisternae, that is the granular cisternae, that is rough endoplasmic reticulum. In liver cell of the salamander, protein crystals have been found in the granular cisternae, that is a cisternae of rough endoplasmic reticulum. The ER thus, the endoplasmic reticulum thus has a property similar to that of Golgi complex, namely concentration of products into the dense granules. So, similar to the vesicles of the Golgi complex, the vesicles of endoplasmic reticulum also performing the function of enclosing different substances either in the form of proteins, in the form of concentrated part, in the form of granules. So, granules of the dense granules of the proteins, which are found in the pancreatic cells of the dog in a cisternae, and also the liver cells of the salamander possessing protein crystals in the cisternae of rough endoplasmic reticulum and thus performing the function of storage or the concentration of the proteins synthesized by the rough endoplasmic reticulum similar to the Golgi complex. Then next function, intracellular transport. Proteins including enzymes, lipids and other cellular materials are transported and distributed to the various parts of the cell through the ER. In some cases these materials, that is enzymes, proteins or lipids, whatever are produced intracellularly, that are transported by the ER from one part of the cell to the other part of the cell, or maybe from interior to the exterior of the cells. And these materials may accumulate and may be stored within the ER for a considerable time. So, intracellular transport of the proteins, enzymes, lipids, and other cellular materials which are produced in the cell cytoplasm are either stored in the endoplasmic reticulum for some time or may be transported from one part of the cell to the other part of the cell or from one end of the cell to the other end of the cell so as to discharge them to the outside through the plasma membrane, or maybe exocytosed from one part of the cell or interior of the cell to the periphery of the cell via ER or endoplasmic reticulum. That is intracellular transport of the proteins, enzymes, or the lipids or other cellular materials which are either transported from one end of the cell or one part of the cell to the other part, or may be stored for some time in the ER for considerable time. Then next function, that is the detoxification. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum, smooth ER, is involved in the detoxification of many endogenous and exogenous compounds. So many endogenous or exogenous means the many toxic substances or the products, many toxic products may be produced intracellularly or may taken or entering into the cell, that is exogenous compounds. So, the exogenous or endogenous compounds which are harmful or toxic to the cell are neutralized or detoxified by smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Prolonged administration of the certain drugs, prolonged or long time administration or consumption of certain drugs like phenobarbital results in the increased activity of enzymes related to detoxification. Prolonged administration of certain drugs like phenobarbital results into increased activity of enzymes related to the detoxification, as well as other enzymes, and a considerable hypertrophy or increase in size of the smooth ER. So, ultimately, it is indicated that smooth endoplasmic reticulum getting involved in the process of detoxification of the endogenous or exogenous compounds which are either harmful or toxic to the cell, so that are neutralized or detoxified by the enzyme activities which are occurring in the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, can result into the increased enzyme activity in the cells, or which also shows considerable hypertrophy or increase in a size of the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, indicating that smooth endoplasmic reticulum thus getting involved in the process of detoxification of the drugs in the smooth endoplasmic reticulum because of increased rate of enzyme activity in the smooth ER, or the hypertrophy or increased size of smooth ER represents its role in a drug detoxification. Membrane flow, another function, membrane flow, transport of ions, molecules, and the particles into and out of the cell may also take place through the membrane flow, and thus substances like RNA and nuclear proteins may pass out from the nucleus to the outside of the cell by the following route. So, membrane flow. So, the different components which are produced in the nucleoplasm or in the nucleus, different components or the different substances like RNAs and nuclear proteins, different substances such as RNAs, different type of RNAs, and nuclear proteins pass from the nucleus to the outside of the cell through a typical path, through a specific path, that is nuclear membrane pores. Different substances like RNA and the nuclear proteins from nucleoplasm pass through the nuclear pore complex of the nuclear envelope or nuclear membrane, then rough ER, then smooth ER, then Golgi complex, then plasma membrane, and then to the outside. So this is the membrane flow of different substances from nucleoplasm to the cytoplasm, or from cytoplasm to the outside of the cell through the plasma membrane. Particles enter the cell by reverse membrane involving pinocytosis and phagocytosis by the plasma membrane, and vesicle formation, that is endocytosis, that is also happening in the cell, that is the passage of substances like RNA or nuclear proteins from nucleus to cytoplasm to the outside. But certain substances from the outside of the cell can also be received through the plasma membrane into the vesicles, maybe in the form of pinocytic vesicles or the phagocytic vesicles, together called as endocytosis, can also occur in the cell through the different membranes, maybe plasma membrane, maybe vesicles, maybe Golgi bodies, maybe endoplasmic reticulum, maybe nuclear envelope or nuclear membrane. So there is a two-way transportation, or the membrane flow. There is a two-way transportation of the materials or the substances from inside to the outside of the cells, and from outside to the inside of the cells, either through the process of exocytosis or endocytosis, representing membrane flow. Then ionic gradients. The sarcoplasmic reticulum of the striated muscles is involved in increase in the concentration of calcium ions by an energy using ATP. The sarcoplasmic reticulum of striated muscle is involved in increase in the concentration of calcium ions. So ionic gradient of the calcium ions can also be maintained or regulated by sarcoplasmic reticulum of the striated muscles in presence of energy using ATP. The calcium ions are stored in the sarcoplasmic reticulum. When the muscle is stimulated by nerve impulses or by hormone or by other means, the calcium ions are released, leading to muscular contraction. So ionic gradient, that is a storage of calcium ions in the sarcoplasmic reticulum of the striated muscles. When the muscle is stimulated either by nerve impulses or by hormone or by other means, the calcium ions are released out from the sarcoplasmic reticulum of the striated muscles, and this leads to the muscular contraction, leading into the muscle contraction or muscular contraction. So this ionic gradient can also be regulated or maintained by the sarcoplasmic reticulum of the striated muscles, which is involved in the increase in a concentration of calcium ions using energy in the form of ATP. So the calcium ions are stored in the sarcoplasmic reticulum, and which are responsible for the muscle concentration whenever there is a stimulation of the striated muscles by nerve impulse or hormone or by other means, leading into release of calcium ions from the sarcoplasmic reticulum in the striated muscles, leading into muscular contraction or the movement of the striated muscles. Then another function, formation of plasmodesmata. Electron microscopic studies suggest that endoplasmic reticulum in the plants plays a special role in the interconnection of the cells through the cytoplasmic strands or the bridge called as plasmodesmata. So the plasmodesmata between the plant cells are formed by the endoplasmic reticulum. So endoplasmic reticulum in plant cells plays a special role in the formation of a bridge or interconnection of the cells through the cytoplasmic strands called as plasmodesmata. So plasmodesmata are formed by the endoplasmic reticulum between the adjacent plant cells and connecting or forming a bridge or the interconnection between the cells by means of plasmodesmata, and are supposed to be produced by the endoplasmic reticulum in a plant cells. Then another function, formation of secondary wall. In the formation of secondary cell wall in a plants, so certain enzymes and metabolites may be carried by the endoplasmic reticulum to the region of secondary wall formation. Means the formation of secondary wall in the plant cells, means cell wall formation in a plant cells occurs under the influence of certain enzymes and the metabolites which are carried from or provided by the endoplasmic reticulum to the region of the cell where actual secondary cell wall is formed. Then glycogen synthesis and storage, another function performed by endoplasmic reticulum, that is glycogen synthesis and the storage. Residual glycogen has been found associated with the endoplasmic reticulum in fasting animals. It is observed that the residual glycogen found in the endoplasmic reticulum in a fasting animals on recommencement of the feeding, there is an increase in the endoplasmic reticulum glycogen level. So on recommencement of the feeding in a fasting animal, there is increase of glycogen level in the endoplasmic reticulum, indicating that the glycogen synthesis and its storage taking place in the endoplasmic reticulum. The enzyme glucose 6-phosphatase has been reported in the ER of the rat liver cells. Enzyme glucose 6-phosphatase has been reported or found to present in the ER of the rat liver cells. It has been linked to breakdown of glycogen, that is glycogenolysis. It has been linked to the breakdown of glycogen, that is glycogenolysis. And it has been also suggested that smooth endoplasmic reticulum membrane plays a role in the synthesis of glycogen, that is glycogenesis. So the endoplasmic reticulum shows two kind of reactions, that is glycogenolysis with the help of glucose 6-phosphatase enzyme. Glycogen is converted into glucose in presence of enzyme glucose 6-phosphatase. The glycogen is converted to glucose in the ER, endoplasmic reticulum of rat liver cells, and it has been linked to the breakdown of glycogen, that is glycogenolysis. Another mechanism which has also been suggested, that smooth endoplasmic reticulum membranes, SER membranes, plays a role in synthesis of glycogen, that is conversion of glucose to glycogen, that is glycogenesis. Means the endoplasmic reticulum, that is smooth endoplasmic reticulum, is involved in a process of glycogen synthesis and the storage of glycogen also. Then another function, that is lipid synthesis and the storage. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum also getting involved in the synthesis of different type of lipids, maybe phospholipids, glycolipids, phospholipids, glycolipids, cholesterol, or the steroid hormones. So these four type of components in the form of lipids or a complex form of the lipids, complex type of lipids, maybe glycolipids, phospholipids, glycolipids, phospholipids, cholesterol, and the steroid hormones are synthesized in the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So electron microscopic and autoradiographic studies of Stein and Stein in 1967 suggested that the ER endoplasmic reticulum was the site of triglyceride formation. That is, triglyceride is also a lipid. They injected, while performing the experiment of autoradiography, Stein and Stein injected radioactive labeled material 3H palmitate and 3H glycogen into the fasted ethanol treated rat. So Stein and Stein injected radioactive labeled material such as 3H palmitate and 3H glycogen into fasted ethanol treated rats, and it was found that the labeled material was seen in the smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum after 2 minutes. It is indicating that the lipid synthesis, that is a triglyceride formations or lipid synthesis, is found to occurring in the smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum because of evidence or presence of labeled material, radiographic material or radioactive labeled materials which are injected into the fasted ethanol treated rats by Stein and Stein, and within a 2 minutes these radioactive labeled materials, that is 3H palmitate and 3H glycogen, are found in the endoplasmic reticulum, that is a smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum, within 2 minutes. So it is indicating that the triglyceride or lipid synthesis and the storage of lipids occurring in the smooth endoplasmic reticulum as well as rough endoplasmic reticulum. Claudy in 1970 had suggested that triglyceride, that is lipid synthesis, may be limited to the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, while protein and perhaps phospholipids are synthesized in a rough endoplasmic reticulum. So that was Claudy, who explained or suggested that lipids, that is phospholipids, or the triglycerides, or different type of lipids, or the different type of complex lipids, either in the form of phospholipids, glycolipids, triglyceride, then cholesterol, even the steroid hormones are synthesized in a smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and the proteins, different type of proteins or enzymes, are synthesized in the rough endoplasmic reticulum. The smooth ER membrane also appears to be involved in the formation of lipoprotein complexes. The SER is also implicated in the initial stages of the breakdown of fatty acids. Conversion of the fatty acids to the acetyl coenzyme A esters occurs mainly in the ER. So, the smooth endoplasmic reticulum membrane appears to be involved in the formation of lipoprotein complexes. The smooth endoplasmic reticulum is also involved in the initial stages of the breakdown of fatty acids. and also the conversion of fatty acids to the acetyl coenzyme A esters occurs mainly in the endoplasmic reticulum. The ER has been associated with the storage of lipids. The endoplasmic reticulum has associated with the storage of lipids. When starved rats were fed with a corn oil, when starved rats were fed with a corn oil, the oil droplets first appeared in a pinocytic vesicles below the microvilli of intestinal epithelial cells. After about an hour, the lipid was found in the ER and the Golgi complex, and thus the endoplasmic reticulum appears to have a general role in the intracellular storage of the lipids. So endoplasmic reticulum performing the role of intracellular storage of the lipids. So this was proved by the experiment which already we have explained. The ER has been associated with the storage of lipids, and this is proved by performing the experiment, that is, when starved rats fed with corn oil, the oil droplets first appeared in the pinocytic vesicles below the microvilli, just below the plasma membrane or microvilli or the plasma membrane, that is periphery of the cells, at first in the form of pinocytic vesicles. So the oil droplets which are entering into the cell just beneath the microvilli in the form of pinocytic vesicles below the microvilli of the intestinal epithelial cells. But after about an hour, these lipids was found in the endoplasmic reticulum and in the Golgi complex, and thus it indicates that the endoplasmic reticulum appears to have a general role in the intracellular storage of the lipids. Then another function of the endoplasmic reticulum, that is the synthesis of cholesterol and steroid hormones. Cholesterol is an important precursor of the steroid hormones. Cholesterol is an important precursor or the substrate of the steroid hormones, and the major site of cholesterol synthesis, the major site of the cholesterol synthesis is the ER, that is smooth ER. In rats injected with a radioactively labeled acetate, merely all labeled cholesterol is found in the microsomal bodies or microbodies or the vesicles containing radioactive labeled cholesterol which was found in the microbodies or the microsomal fractions. The microsomes have also been shown to be the principal sites of the cholesterol forming enzymes. The intermediate squalene and lanosterol in a cholesterol synthesis are bound to the ER in a rat liver cells. So the intermediate components, intermediate products or intermediate components of the cholesterol, that is squalene and lanosterol, these are the intermediate squalene and lanosterol found in a cholesterol synthesis are found or bound to the ER in a rat liver cells, indicating that rat liver cells ER believed to be concerned with synthesis and the storage of the cholesterol. So this was also proved by an experiment, that is the ER is a major site of cholesterol synthesis of cholesterol and the steroid hormones taking place in the endoplasmic reticulum, and cholesterol is an important precursor of the steroid hormones. So cholesterol is synthesized in the ER membrane, which are then used for the synthesis of the steroid hormones. So cholesterol is an important precursor of the steroid hormones, and the ER is major site of the cholesterol synthesis. ER is the major site of the cholesterol synthesis. In rats injected with radioactively labeled acetate, merely all labeled cholesterol is found in the microsomal fraction or the microbodies, which are derived from either ER or the Golgi bodies. But the microsomes have also been shown to be the principal site of the cholesterol forming enzymes. The intermediate, that is squalene and lanosterol, in a cholesterol synthesis are bound or found associated with the ER in a rat liver cells, indicating that the ER of rat liver cells is concerned with the synthesis of cholesterol and storage of the cholesterol. In the testes, ovary and the adrenal cortex, these are the very different organs supposed to performing the role of endocrine gland, that is the synthesis of hormones. So testes, ovary and the adrenal gland, these are the endocrine glands, and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum of testes, ovary and the adrenal cortex perform a role of synthesis of steroid hormones. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum of testes, ovary and the adrenal cortex performs a role of synthesis of steroid hormones, as they are getting the cholesterol, as they are getting cholesterol as a precursor for the synthesis of steroid hormones in the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. A well developed smooth endoplasmic reticulum has been demonstrated in the interstitial cells of the testes of the guinea pig. The enzyme catalyzing biosynthesis of androgens, or the testosterone have been located in the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The enzymes which are essential for the synthesis of androgens or testosterone synthesis are found in the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The enzymes which are essential for the biosynthesis of androgens or the testosterone or the male hormones have been located in a smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and thus there is a strong correlation between the amount of SER in the cells and the capacity to synthesize the steroid hormones. So there is a strong correlation between the amount of smooth endoplasmic reticulum in the testes or interstitial cells or the gland cells of the testes and the capacity of the cells, interstitial cells, to synthesize steroid hormones. So in short, we can say the smooth endoplasmic reticulum of the interstitial cells of the testes or the ovary or the adrenal cortex performing a role of synthesis of cholesterol and steroid hormones. Then next function of the endoplasmic reticulum, that is formation of microbodies. Closely related with ER, endoplasmic reticulum, are the microbodies, which are small granular bodies filled with an electron dense substance with a single membrane. So formation of microbodies. So ER membrane, endoplasmic reticulum membrane, that is either rough endoplasmic reticulum or smooth endoplasmic reticulum, pinching off or budding off the microbodies or the small granular bodies filled with electron dense substances and bounded by a single membrane or a unit membrane. They have been found in the protozoa, yeast, higher plants, liver and the kidney. In a rat liver cells, there are 70 to 100 microbodies. In a rat liver cells, there are 70 to 100 microbodies with an average diameter of 0.6 to 0.7 micrometer. Microbodies are formed as a dilation of the ER and frequently show the connection with a ER cisternae, indicating that the microbodies are budded up or pinched off from the cisternae of ER just by a dilation of the end of the cisternae. The end portion of the cisternae become dilated and acquires some kind of electron dense material and then pinched off or budded off in the form of microbodies. In case of rat liver cells, there are about 70 to 100 microbodies with a diameter of 0.6 to 0.7 micrometer. Microbodies are formed as a dilation of ER and frequently show connection with the ER cisternae. Means at the time of pinching off, budding off of the microbodies from the cisternae ends can also be found in a process of budding off of the microbodies from the ER cisternae. They are rich in enzyme peroxidase and are hence also called as peroxisomes, catalase and D-amino acid oxidase. So these microbodies which are formed or derived from probably from the cisternae of ER contains different type of enzymes such as peroxidase, then are called as peroxisomes, catalase and D-amino acid oxidase. So different type of enzymes such as peroxidase, catalase and D-amino acid oxidase can also occurring in the microbodies. In plant cells, the enzymatic content is different. And the bodies, that is microbodies, are called as glyoxysomes because they include enzyme of the glycosylate cycle. In case of plant cells, the microbodies which are derived from the endoplasmic reticulum containing different type of enzymes of the glycosylate cycle, and thus these microbodies can be called as glyoxysomes. And the microbodies which are containing enzymes like peroxidase or catalase and D-amino acid oxidase can be called as peroxisomes. And in plant cells, the smooth ER or ER, when forming microbodies containing the enzymes related with the glyoxylate cycle, and thus these microbodies can be called as glyoxysomes. So the formation of microbodies such as peroxisomes or glyoxysomes or spherosomes can occur probably from the ER, endoplasmic reticulum. So this is what the function of formation of microbodies. Then peroxisomes produce oxidative enzymes which generate hydrogen peroxide. The enzymes are urate oxidase, D-amino oxidase and hydroxylic acid oxidase. They produce hydrogen peroxide which is toxic to the cell. Another enzyme produced is a catalase which destroys the hydrogen peroxide and therefore probably plays a protective role. Peroxide shows a relationship with a steroid synthesis and generation of NAD and NADDPH. So these are the energy rich compounds. NAD and NADPH are the energy rich compounds which are supposed to be synthesized by the peroxide. So peroxide shows a relationship with a steroid synthesis and generation of NAD and NADPH. So peroxisomes producing oxidative enzymes which generate or produce hydrogen peroxides, which is a toxic gas. The enzymes are urate oxidase, D-amino oxidase, and hydroxylic acid oxidase. So these three type of enzymes are produced by the peroxisomes, and this will lead to the synthesis of peroxide, hydrogen peroxide. But they also produce the enzyme catalase. These enzymes, that is urate oxidase, D-amino acid oxidase, hydroxylic acid oxidase, these are three type of enzymes called as oxidative enzymes, which produce hydrogen peroxide, which is toxic to the cell. And another enzyme produced by the peroxisome is called as catalase, which destroys or neutralize the hydrogen peroxide. So therefore, the peroxisomes performs a protective role in the cell, that is neutralization or disintegration or destruction of the hydrogen peroxide by synthesizing the catalase, by synthesizing the catalase enzyme, which performs protective role in the cell, that is the destruction or neutralization of hydrogen peroxide by catalase enzyme, which is also synthesized by peroxisomes. So peroxide shows a relationship with a steroid synthesis and generation of NAD and NADPH. Another function of the ER, origin of cell organelles. There are evidences that show ER is the place for the origin of the organelles known as primary lysosomes. So primary lysosomes are supposed to be derived from the ER membrane or the endoplasmic reticulum. Origin of cell organelles, that is, there is a evidence of showing endoplasmic reticulum is the place for the origin of the organelle such as primary lysosomes. Then it also performs the role in the amphibian development. There are evidences to suggest that endoplasmic reticulum contributes. There are evidences or the proof to suggest that the endoplasmic reticulum contributes in a several ways to the development of the amphibian embryo. Then cell differentiation. The endoplasmic reticulum is important in the process of cell differentiation and coordinating the differentiation. The endoplasmic reticulum performing the important role in the process of cell differentiation and coordinating the process of cell differentiation. So this is what about the functions of endoplasmic reticulum. So today with this, we'll stop here, and next time we'll continue with the next point. Thank you.